Thank you. Christ. I think they can hear us in downtown Ljubljana now.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, 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 Hare
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai technology. So before the actual class, I would like to play something by Srila Prabhupada, which is a little talk that Prabhupada gave to Satsarup Maharaj in London in July of 1973. It's about 5 minutes. It's quick. It's probably longer than that, but what's recorded is 5 minutes. And it's about the holy name. So I found it very, what we say, to the point of what Prabhupada expects or is encouraging us to focus on in our practice of Krishna consciousness. Let's see how technology favors us here or doesn't. This thing close to this. Need some yoga here. So this is Prabhupada speaking.
So we should not increase this home very much. So shortcuts. That's all. Our real business is our love, Tattavadan, Naradhar, Vesai, Savaya, Sakyuraki, Smartha, Jadavasa. They have been condemned by Bhaktivinoda. Smartha and Jadavasa. Smart Pandit, very serious about performing ceremonial rituals. They are called Smarthas. This is Hari Bhakti Vilas also, Vaishnava Smriti, that is also an imitation of Smarthism. It is called Smriti. So, at least in Europe and America, they will never be able to take on these things. things should be made shortcut. At the same time, they should be successful. So that is chanting of Hare Krishna. Depending on it. As soon as you have got some time, chant Hare Krishna. Either loudly or silently, as far as possible, loudly. If not possible, silently. But the tongue must go, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. The tongue must work. And as far as possible, it should be heard. That is clear. And officially, not like that. That is not. Every word should be distinctly chanted and heard, not official. So stress on this point, as far as possible, people should be encouraged to chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra and try to bring the ecstasy and dance. Even there is no ecstasy, dance, it will bring ecstasy. Dancing is nice. Chanting, dancing, and take prasad, take rest, that's all. Not that you shall take rest like Kumbhakarna. Just to answer the call of the deficient body, we have to take a little rest. But as far as possible, this will be conquered. Nidrahara vihara kadi vijito. The Goswami is the conquered man, eating, sleeping. Stress and sankita. I let them chant and dance as long as possible. If they can chant and dance 24 hours, that is very good. That should be station. You see, this boy yesterday, he came, he said, I like this Sankirtan very much. Immediately. He was talking so much, yoga, this and that, so many nonsense. But he came this morning and he said, oh, I am coming in. It is very nice. Sankirtan has got some power. Stress on Sankirtan. Chant yourself, induce others, dance. More thing is something. And especially outside India, these rituals and ceremonials, that will be simply artificial. They cannot take it seriously. But Sankirtan they can take seriously. This is practical. And if you recite all the basic hymns throughout the whole day, they will join, but they will not benefit out of it. Why should you waste? Is that all right?
Yes. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. I think that was right to the point. He said, he kept saying the word stress on this. So that's a little bit of a prelude to the class, which the verse and the purport is also to enhance Prabhupada's statement. And of course, he's saying it again here in this particular verse. So we can begin. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo
Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So this is Canto 6, Chapter 3, Verse 25. Yamaraj instructs his messenger. Prayena Vedatam Idam Namaha Jayam Prayena Veda Tamidam Namaha Janoyam. Devya Vimohita Matir Bhattamaya Yalham. Trayam Jadi Kriti Matir Maru Pushpitayam. Vatanike Mahati Karmani Yujamanaha. Prayena Veda Tamidam Na Mahajanoyam. Devya Vimohita Matir Bhattamaya Yalam. Trayam Jati Kriti Matir Maru Pushpitayam. Vaitanike Mahiti Karmani Ujyamanaha.
Vaitanike Mahati Karmani Ujyamanaha.
Chant.
Madhupushpitaya. Kayena Veda Tadinam Namaha Chanoya. Devya Vimohita Matir Vatamaya Yalam. Rayam jati krita matir madhu pushpitaya. Vaitani ke mahati karmani yujamana.
Prayena.
Almost always.
Veda.
Know.
Tat.
That.
Idam.
This.
Na.
Not
Mahajana.
Great personalities
besides Swayambhu,
Shambhu,
and the other ten.
Ayam,
this
Devya.
By the energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Vimohita Mati,
whose intelligence is bewildered.
Bhata,
indeed.
Mayaya,
by the illusionary energy.
Alam,
greatly.
Twayam,
in the three Vedas.
Jarikrita Mati,
whose intelligence has been dulled.
Marupushpatayam,
in the flowery Vedic language, describing the results of ritualistic performances.
Vaitanike,
in the performances mentioned in the Vedas.
Mahati,
very great.
Karmani,
fruit of activities.
Yujamanaha,
being engaged. So this is Yamaraj speaking to his messengers. They've just come back from being thwarted in their attempt to take the soul of Ajamil to Yamaraj for punishment. And now he's speaking, and this is a few verses into his speech, and now he's explaining a little bit about those great souls who really are more or less ritualistic. Because they are bewildered by the illusionary energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Yajnavalkya and Jamini and other compilers of the religious scriptures cannot know the secret confidential religious system of the 12 Mahajans. They cannot understand the transcendental value of performing devotional service or chanting Hare Krishna mantra. Because their minds are attracted to ritualistic ceremonies mentioned in the Vedas, especially the Yajurveda, Samaveda, and Rigveda, their intelligence has become dull. Thus, they are busy collecting the ingredients for ritualistic ceremonies that yield only temporary benefits, such as elevations to Swargaloka for material happiness. They are not attracted to the Sankirtan movement. Instead, they are interested in Dharma, Artha, Kama, and Moksha. So, he's explaining the other great personalities who are simply interested in elevation through various forms of rituals. Purport. Since one may easily achieve the highest success by chanting the holy name of the Lord, one may ask why there are so many Vedic ritualistic ceremonies and why people are attracted to them. This verse answers that question. As stated in Bhagavad Gita 15:15, Vedaischa Sivam Aham Veda Vedya. The real purpose of studying the Vedas is to approach the lotus feet of Lord Krishna. Unfortunately, unintelligent persons, bewildered by the grandeur of Vedic yajnas, want to see gorgeous sacrifices performed. They want Vedic mantras chanted and huge amounts of money spent for such ceremonies. Sometimes we have to observe the Vedic ritualistic ceremonies to please such unintelligent men. Recently, when we established the large Krishna Balaram temple in Vrindavan, we were obliged to have Vedic ceremonies enacted by the Brahmins, because the inhabitants of Vrindavan, especially the smarta Brahmanas, would not accept Europeans and Americans as bona fide Brahmanas. Thus, we had to engage Brahmanas to perform costly yagyas. In spite of these yagyas, the members of our society performed Sankirtan loudly with mridanga, and I considered the Sankirtan more important than the Vedic ritualistic ceremonies. Prabhupada went through a lot of arrangement to bring about these Vedic ritualistic ceremonies, and he explains why here. Because they would not accept those of us who are coming from foreign countries as being, what we say, bona fide, and therefore our temple would not have been considered to be an authorized temple within the Vrindavan scheme. Did all this honor. But at the same time, he kept the kirtan going while the ceremonies were going on. Both the ceremonies and the Sankirtan were going on simultaneously. The ceremonies were meant for persons interested in Vedic rituals for elevation to heavenly planets. Jadi Kriti Mati Madhu Pushpitayam. Whereas the Sankirtan was meant for pure devotees interested in pleasing the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We would have simply have performed Sankirtan, but then the inhabitants of Vrindavan would not have taken the installation ceremony seriously. As explained here, the Vedic performances are meant for those whose intelligence has been dulled by the flowery language of the Vedas, which describe fruitive activities intended to elevate one to higher planets. Especially in this age of Kali, Sankirtan alone is sufficient. If the members of our temple in different parts of the world simply continue Sankirtan before the deity, especially before Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then they will remain perfect. There is no need for any other performances. Nevertheless, to keep oneself clean in habits and mind, deity worship and other regulative principles are required. Srila Jiva Goswami says that although Sankirtan is sufficient for the perfection of life, the archanam, or worship of the deity in the temple, must continue in order that devotees may stay clean and pure. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur therefore recommended that one follow both processes simultaneously. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur therefore recommended that we follow both processes simultaneously. We strictly follow the principles of performing deity worship and Sankirtan along parallel lines. This we should continue. Om Agyan Timidandasya Gana Jana Salakaya Chaksu Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapditam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swam Padatikam Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktivinoda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So in the atmosphere of our kirtan program here for 4 days, I think this is very appropriate. And then, of course, we hear so much, and of course it's repeated in various ways, about the importance of chanting the holy names of the Lord. And I think, from what my own experience is, we can't hear it enough. Just to, what we say, drill it into our heads, that this is really where our success is. And it's so simple. It's so easy just to chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Prabhupada says it takes tongue and ears. That's all. And a little bit of, what we say, enthusiasm. And then, as of course, a little enthusiasm is initial in order to inspire greater amounts of enthusiasm through the initial enthusiasm. But again, of course, here, Prabhupada, after what we say, pretty much, we might say, strongly speaking against those who perform ritualistic ceremonies, following in the verse by Yamaraj, and saying, pretty much this is, you know, people who are interested in a lot of this grandeur, it looks nice. Sometimes we do that in order to attract, outsiders. I think, oh, just like if you go to one of our Hare Krishna weddings, and there's so much pomp and color and rituals and mantras and various types of, activities going on. Sometimes one marriage went on for 7 hours, just a ceremony. It was in India, of course, and it was our temple, it was our devotees. You had these Brahmins performing this very elaborate Vedic marriage. And, you know, when you advertise like this, you really get a crowd. Even in the West, people are attracted by that. We did that in Kitanagari one time. I was there with Bhakti Tirtha Swami back in the early part of the century. And there was Chaturatma. Chaturatma, he's a great priest. He knows various forms of rituals and ceremonies. So he was commissioned to do the wedding. And he did, and the interesting thing about it was there was 7 couples that were getting married. Bhakti Tirtha Swami would do this once a year and have a grand wedding on a particular weekend in May. It was always in May. And at the same time, he would have initiations on one day and marriages on the other day. And so this time they invited all the relatives of all the devotees. And it was about 50 relatives. They came from all over America to see their children get married. And they were just sitting there watching this very elaborate ceremony. And you can see they were really thinking, boy, this is nice. I couldn't wait till it was over. I was thinking, no, prasadam is a little bit more engaging than this for me. But it went on and on, and you could see their eyes were getting big, and they were kind of looking at each other and smiling. And then the whole thing went on, and it took hours and hours. Finally, we finished, and then I don't know why I'm going to tell this story, but I'll tell it anyway. Is that right after that, there was a play by one of Maharaj's leading disciples, Yasodamayi. You know about Yasodamayi? And she did the play. This was right after the wedding. She did the play with the Brahmin who sits on the banks of the holy river, and he has 2 pairs of kopins, and that's his only possession. This is right after a wedding. And so the story is, you know, this Brahmin, you know, he's wearing one and he washes one and hangs it up, but there's a mouse keeps chewing on that one. So he's thinking, okay, what can I do here? This is the only thing I have, and I need it. So someone advised him, well, you can get a cat to keep the mouse away. So he gets a cat to keep the mouse away. And then after the cat's doing good to keep the mouse away, but then, it's hungry. So he needs something. And cats like milk. So someone told him, you should get a cow. So, okay, they have to keep the cat with milk and so he can keep the mouse away from the copins. So he gets this cow, and then, you know, he has to milk the cow, and then he feeds the cat, and the cat does his, service. And then there's But then after a while, he's thinking, I have to maintain this cow, and I have to really, I have to, cow needs some hay and some feed, and I have to take care of it, and I can't even do my bhajan. Someone said, well, you should get a wife. Take care of the cow. So he thinks that's a good idea. So he gets a wife to take care of the cow, who has to, she milks the cow now, he can go back to his bhajan. And she takes, and then she feeds the cat, and the cat, you know, keeps the mouse away. But then after a while, the wife says, you know, I can't live like this. You know, I need the house. So he's thinking, I have to have a, take care of my wife, who has to milk the cow, to take care of the cat, to feed the... So she wants a house, and he's thinking, now I have to get a job. So this is right after a wedding, you know, all these new people. So I'm sitting there next to Bhakti Tirtha Swami, and I'm looking, I said, Maharaj, did you know about this play? He said, no. And it just went on. And all these guests, after seeing this grand wedding, they're watching this play. And I was thinking, I hope they don't get the message. And then somehow it went on successfully, apparently successfully anyway. And they didn't seem to be the slightest bit disturbed by the play. So, rituals and performances and all these things. But we see when we just have Harinam Sankirtan, how many people are attracted to that. And Prabhupada said, just do two things, emphasize two things. Of course, we do others, but he said, emphasize prasadam distribution in Harinam Sankirtan. He says, this is the way to preach in the age of Kali, especially. People are not so much inclined to understand various types of performances, and at the same time, they're not needed. And then Prabhupada also says, and as far as philosophy is concerned, we can speak in our temples. But generally, people are more attracted and able to, what we say, assimilate and understand and take part in Harinam Sankirtan. So this is emphasized here. But, then Prabhupada goes on, but we have to keep the deity worship going. Parallel lines. Bhagavad Vidhi, Harinam Sankirtan, Pancharatriki Vidhi, also. Worshipping of the deity that way. If the Lord is worshipped nicely, and the devotees practice the principles for deity worship. And deity worship does not only mean when those who are on the altar. When we're in the temple, there's a form of what we say, etiquette, that must go on before the deities to help to purify our consciousness and to understand that Krishna is there in the form of Panchatattva. And so deity worship means temple work, temple activities like that. So we offer our obeisances to the Lord, we pray to the Lord, we bring things to the temple to offer to the Lord, we can bring flowers and in other words, this purifies, it helps us develop brahminical qualities and also keeps, as Prabhupada said, very suci, because deity worship means the highest form of cleanliness. So these things, and of course, the actual spiritual benefit from worshiping the deity is that when the Lord is pleased by such worship, he bestows his mercy. And especially with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he's bestowing his mercy by encouraging us take part in the Harinam Sankirtan. So these two things, and Prabhupada emphasizes, chant the holy names and worship the Lord in his transcendental form as the deity, Archivigraha worship. And as far as our activities are concerned, chant Hare Krishna and distribute the mercy of Krishna consciousness to others. Just like I was noticing last night and the night before, there were many guests who were coming. There was one person who came last night. He was a person we preached to in one prison. And he came for the first time and he brought his two children. And he was he actually stayed till after 10 o'clock last night. So the holy name, chanting of the holy name, singing, dancing, and eating. Prabhupada made a point one time. He was wanted to emphasize a point. So he was saying, this Hare Krishna movement is simply chanting, dancing, and feasting. That's all. But Prabhupada, we got so... No, chanting, dancing, and feasting. That is all. I was chanting my japa this morning. I was just thinking, boy, this movement is a lot of fun. I don't know, I just got this feeling of happiness this morning. It wasn't from the japa. but it was just, I felt this thing. I said, what a great life. You sing, you dance, you eat, and you gotta die anyway, so. But you could sing and dance and eat until you die. It's great. And you can read some books too. What else is there to do? And then, of course, the thought came up, well, about grihastha life. And I said, well, I don't have to worry about that. But anyway, I pray for her. But grihastha life, sing, dance, eat, and do the same thing. Why work so hard? I tell this story. Of course, this is another one of those stories that you might not like. It's a pastime from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's, from his Leelas, where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu approaches Srivas Thakur, and he says, Srivas Thakur, you're a grihastha, you have a big family, but how do you maintain your family? You don't work, you don't do anything. And Srivas Thakur responded in the most unusual way. He went, that was the response. And Lord Chaitanya said, what does that mean? And Srivas said, my dear Lord, if the Lord doesn't feed me for one day, if he doesn't feed me and my family, take care of us for 2 days, and if he doesn't do it for 3 days, then I jump in the Ganges and drown myself. Lord Chaitanya roared. He roared so loudly it shook the universe. He said, Srivas, you are so fortunate. Even if the goddess of fortune, Lakshmi, has to go from door to door to beg in order to live, there will always be food in your house. Everything will be taken care of. In other words, he had such faith in the chanting of the holy names and engaging in the process of pure devotional service that Lord Chaitanya said, yeah, Krishna will always take care of you. There's no problem. So sometimes I tell that to mixed audiences such as this. I might tell you not to quit your job, but you should know it's not necessary. I hope nobody's not recording this particular lecture. If we have the faith of Srivas Thakur, of course, if we have the faith of Srivas Thakur, he had full faith, he had 100% plus faith, then one can actually think in that way. But the idea is that Krishna takes care of his devotees. He always takes care of the needs of his devotees. So the more we take shelter of Krishna's holy name in the Sankirtan movement, the more we can experience how Krishna takes care of his devotees. He arranges for everything. Just because he wants to serve his devotees, he wants to see his devotees able to have everything they need to engage in devotional service. And if they want something more, yeah, he'll also provide that. If it doesn't take away from their devotional service. That's Krishna. He's so merciful. And his mercy is manifested so much in the form of Mahaprabhu. Lord Shiva, when Prabhupada would speak about the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he would become overwhelmed with emotion. And sometimes he couldn't even speak, just thinking of how merciful Lord Chaitanya was. And sometimes he would challenge us just to try to understand Lord Chaitanya's mercy. It's impossible. No one can understand. Even if one has all the acumen of a great intellect, still they cannot understand the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is allowing or giving the highest to everyone in the form of this Sankirtan movement. Everyone is coming. Everyone is welcome. Everyone's encouraged to come. Everyone is encouraged to take part. And everyone is able, or what we say, eligible by His mercy to perform pure devotional service. Only by His mercy. Otherwise, what is our situation? But everything centers around chanting the holy names of the Lord. Giriraj Maharaj tells one story. When Prabhupada was in Vrindavan, this was it was around 1972, I believe, was just when Prabhupada was beginning the movement. He was with a kirtan group in Vrindavan. They were singing so beautiful. And they were singing various forms of bhajan. And Prabhupada was really, really, really feeling happy, just listening to their body. Later he turned to the devotees, he said, we should do this, we should sing all the time. We should chant all the time. We should chant 24 hours. We should have 24-hour kirtan every day. And of course, you know, the devotees were kind of bewildered. You know, we got so many other sermons. Then Prabhupada said, we should do it at least every weekend for 3 days, every weekend. And another place in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, when he's describing the pastime of how Lord Chaitanya spent approximately a month at the house of a Dvaitacharya just after taking sannyas, before he took his trek to Jagannath Puri. And Lord Chaitanya, after some time, decided to leave. And of course, just the separation from the Lord was just too much for the devotees, especially for Sri Advaita. And as the Lord was leaving, Sri Advaita was following, and he was begging the Lord, please stay for another 3 or 5 days. Lord Chaitanya's heart became, what we say, softened by, it's always soft, but even more so. And he turned around, he came back, and he stayed for another week at the house. And it says they were, during that whole time, all day, they were just listening to Krishna Katha, and in the evening they were having kirtan. That was the only activity. And Prabhupada in the purport writes, three things were going on: Hari Katha, Hari Kirtan, Hari Puja. Chanting the glories of the Lord, the holy name, worshipping the Lord in His deity form, Hari Puja, and hearing and chanting the glories of Krishna's pastimes. That's all that went on for a week. And then Prabhupada writes in another purport right after that, he said, "This we should adopt this immediately in our temples. Every night for 3 hours, we should have Harinam Sankirtan in our temples. This should be done immediately." So when we hear, you know, like, Prabhupada is just emphasizing over and over again how important it is to chant the holy names, to purify ourselves through the holy names, to invite others to chant the holy names, and to distribute Krishna prasadam. Make the prasadam so nice that people don't even want to leave, what to speak about coming back. Prabhupada said the prasadam should be so tasty that when people come, they think, I'm not going anywhere else. This is real. So he wanted the best possible prasadam to be distributed. And he said, this is very attractive, especially in Western countries. Harinam Sankirtan and nice, succulent, what we say, plentiful prasadam. He told the cooks in one discussion, in one temple, he said, actually it was a lecture, or it was a kind of like a room conversation discussion. He said, in all our temples, we should cook puris, halva, chutney, sabji, and keep it available throughout the entire day. And when people come, they get a nice plate of prasadam. Anyone who comes, and if there's anything left over at the end of the evening, the devotees can take. Prabhupada said that. He wanted mass prasadam distribution. Anyone who comes, take prasadam and come into the nice atmosphere and hear about Krishna and chant the holy names. So attractive. Anyone who is attractive to such programs. So this is our Krishna consciousness movement, and Prabhupada emphasizes it very much in these series of verses here, from verse 22 all the way up to verse 26, the following verse. He wants to make the point that the essence of our practice is to hear and chant the holy names of the Lord. And this will purify our consciousness and will attract us to engage more and more in Krishna service. This is the power of our, and it's very powerful. As we are speaking now, there's another major kirtan program going on in America called Sadhu Sangha, with some of the leading devotees all over the world have come for that one. So that's another three-day festival. So if we continue to do this throughout the world, gradually the world will become more and more purified. This is the purification. Just continue to have these programs and attract more and more people. And there's a taste, a sweet taste. I noticed last night when the devotees were chanting, I was 10:30, and then I was told I had to give class the next morning. And I said, I don't want to leave. But I had to, because Prabhupada said, you have to take a little rest to maintain the decrepit body. So I had to leave. But I noticed the temple was really full last night at 10:30. It was amazingly full. It was more devotees there than it was here now. It was really going on last night, and devotees were really enthusiastic. So this is our life. We forget about sleeping and forget about other things. Just chant the holy names of the Lord. And it purifies the entire atmosphere. And what to speak about this, and Lord Chaitanya's movement started from Navadvipa. It says like a raging river that begins its rush and all its rivulets stream throughout the rest of the area. So Lord Chaitanya's movement has started from Navadvipa, and it's sending floods of nectar in the form of the Harinam Sankirtan all over the world. So this verse is really, really fundamental, because here Prabhupada makes the point, following in the footsteps of this particular translation. All these rituals and all these ceremonies, they may be very nice, very colorful, but just like I remember, like Chaturmasya. Of course, we follow Chaturmasya. Prabhupada said in a very simple way. We follow, we restrict from one type of foodstuffs each month. But actually, the principle of Chaturmasya is very elaborate. For 4 months, it's very austere. So I remember when we were starting to do this Chaturmasya ritual in New Vrindavan. And one of the things you have to do is you eat once a day, and you eat khichdi. You put your hands behind your back, there's a plate of khichdi on the floor in front of you, and you go down without touching it, you eat like that. And then as soon as you come up, that's all you get for that whole day. You do that for 4 months. And then we found out, what's the result? You get to the heavenly planets. This was the benefit of this Chaturmasya ritual. So, but Prabhupada said, all right, he gave us a little restriction. So there's so many various forms of ceremonies and rituals for purification. And Prabhupada makes this point very clearly. We could have had just the Harinam Sankirtan in our installation in a Krishna Balaram temple. But we would not be taken seriously by the Brahmins in Vrindavan. Therefore, they would not authorize our temple. So therefore, we had to do all this. So Prabhupada's showing just the power of chanting the holy names of the Lord. Everything becomes purified. Okay, so I think everyone here sort of understands this point. Otherwise, we wouldn't be here for this weekend. The importance of chanting the holy names, importance of inspiring others to chant the holy names. Any questions or comments? Yes? Can a couple get married also by chanting? I have to refer that to those who have more knowledge on this subject. Does any of our senior devotees want to take a shot at this one? Maharaj, Lakshmi Moni? I'm sure Lakshmi Moni has insight on this one.
And, many places it goes on, like you were saying, for a very long time. It's many hours, sometimes many days.
Days, yes,
and
yeah.
If you're in the right place,
or wrong place, either one.
And it makes a groove, a mark in your brain, you're married.
Yeah. Oh, I see, the emphasize. Impression.
That impression is important. So for those people who are very advanced, we see sometimes maybe they just get married by chanting Hare Krishna, but or something. But for us,
then they get divorced by chanting Hare Krishna.
But for us, the samskara is important.
Yeah. So this is a good point. The importance of making that impression. Samskara means, you know, a life, what we say, there's certain stages in life you have to go through. So to make it understandable and to stress the importance of such things, it's very important that once you make that vow, it's a lifelong vow. At least, of course, you finish your responsibilities in that ashram without jumping from person to person. In other words, take it seriously. Take it seriously. It's not a small thing.
I just wanted to say something about the installation of Krishna Balaram.
Yes, please.
And even if you look at the video now of that ceremony, Srila Prabhupada sat there and did whatever he was told. He put rice in his hand and threw it. But his whole countenance was completely not there. Even though his body was doing this and that, he didn't even smile. He was just completely like... you could really sense that he was just doing this as an obligation.
I think maybe he wanted to send a message too. Was well attended by these other people?
It was well attended. It was attended enough that people would criticize. Prabhupada was very conscious of that, that we should behave in such a way that we wouldn't be criticized. And that spilled over into other behaviors too, like the way husband and wife associated in public and the way we behaved when we went into town. And,
right.
You know, Prabhupada was very concerned that they wouldn't think badly of us, or they thought badly of us.
Yeah.
They didn't want it to think worse of us.
Yeah. They couldn't find some reason to criticize. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah. You know, Prabhupada's preaching according to time, place, and circumstance. Yeah, but he made that point, and that was necessary.
He also made a comment about Chaturmasa. He said, whatever leads to Chaturmasa becomes
Chaturmasa. What is that?
Chaturmasa.
Chaturmasa.
Sanskrit and English.
Chaturmasa. Thank you, Maharaj.
Just a footnote to Lakshmi Moni Mataji's comments about the Vrindavan installation. I was not there, but many years later I visited one of the priests who did the rituals of installation in the ISKCON Hyderabad temple, South India.
Hmm.
Very nice man, very just very nice and very learned pundit, and we were chatting, and it was the same thing in Hyderabad. Prabhupada had arranged for these rituals to be done because it needed to be seen a certain way and so on.
Mm.
This man, Sampat Kumar Bhattacharya, I visited him at his home so many years later. And very proudly he brought out the letter of thanks that he received from Srila Prabhupada. And in the letter it says, of course we understand that what really matters is the chanting of Hare Krishna. So he was preaching in the letter at the same time as thanking him for having done all the rituals. But it was so interesting that, sort of ironically, he was, you know, very proud of this lecture, saying this, and he was the one who had done all of this ritual, which Srila Prabhupada, you know, just considered as superficial.
He was happy because he got Prabhupada's blessings. More contemporary, I was just thinking, I was in Tirupati in 2007, and the temple president there, Revati Raman Prabhu, wonderful, wonderful Vaishnava. In order to also give some credence and authority to our temple, and he invited some of the pundits from the Tirupati temple, which they had developed somewhat of a relationship beforehand, to come. And one of their chief pundits came, the chief pundit came, along with the chief person who does what we say ceremonies. And he did the puja. He was the main person who did the puja. And that went on for hours and hours and hours, and he chanted all kinds of mantras. But it was necessary. And that really gave us much more acceptability in the Tirupati temple, which till today is still a good relationship. And Tirupati is very famous. So, yeah.
There was a Brahman who told me that when he was doing the ceremony, he had to carry on his head a brass pot
mm-hmm.
and he had to.
I did it too. I was there. I was carrying something on my head.
The weight of the deities, the whatever, the rocks on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. To take care of them for the rest of their life, it was a big responsibility.
Mm. Yeah, I remember. Now you're bringing back memories. I had to put something. I can't remember what I put on my head, but it was something I carried from the door to the altar. Also, I don't think it was rocks, though. It was something.
I don't know what it was. He just told me it was the weight of the deities. Mm. You know, the same
mm.
weight.
And that was, there was 10 deities installed. Radha and Krishna and the Astasakis. So, just like Mayapur. Yeah, and sometimes it's necessary, but Prabhupada was always there to help us understand that, okay, but really, the essence of our purification comes with chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. And the deity worship we perform is necessary to help us develop brahminical qualities so we can chant the holy name with devotion. Okay, any other questions? Anyone? Okay, thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai.
Thank you.